Are you a watch addict? I think I used to be one when I started collecting watches, but no longer. Let's discuss the signs and try to distinguish between a watch addict and a watch enthusiast on this episode of Adventures with Time. My watch collecting activities that I've chronicled through this channel, you may remember that my first year I purchased a dozen watches and the second year I added another six. Does that mean that I had a watch addiction? Not necessarily. Let me state clearly from the outset that my intent is not to minimize or make light of issues associated with an addiction. They are serious and not to be made light of. However, the term watch addict is often applied to watch collectors more readily than indicated by the compulsive psychological need associated with an addiction. Watch collectors use this term to describe enthusiasts who buy a lot of watches, sometimes one right after another, and sometimes multiple watches at a time. In reality, rarely does a psychological dependence to acquire a new watch get to the point where one gets depressed or ill when we don't have a new watch inbound. Seldom do our collecting activities become detrimental to our financial or physical well-being. Still, watch enthusiasts, especially when starting out, can become obsessed with the hobby. This may originate from the need to fill slots in one's watch box or complete some set of watches, or the desire to learn about horology and experience new watches. More often, I believe, it comes from the thrill of acquiring something new. We see a watch that is different in some way from what we already have, and we want to get it, and get it now. Do we really want and need that new watch we're seeing? Or is it just the idea of unboxing some new shiny item? One may not even have had sufficient time with the most recent watch added to our collection to determine if we like it before we are looking to scratch that itch with another watch. This is the point at which we tag people as watch addicts. Again, we are using this term to refer to someone who buys watches at a fast rate, even if they flip these watches. Entering into this hobby, I had little experience with watches and no experience with different shapes, materials, complications, or watch types. I dove in strong, buying about one new watch a month to broaden my exposure to watches. I was somewhat selective with my purchases. I didn't just buy any watch. I did some investigation to minimize the risk of mistakes. Nor did I buy beyond my financial means. And I wasn't driven by filling a watch box. In fact, my first watch box had just six slots. Oh, how naive I was. I quickly outgrew this watch box and purchased a 10 and then a 24 slot box at a necessity to hold my expanding collection. During these early months, shortly after I received a new watch, I went searching for my next purchase. This went on for about 18 months. Do I consider that I was a watch addict or was I just an aggressive watch enthusiast? I'm not sure it matters what terminology we use. The important point is that I didn't spend money beyond my means. Rarely did I spend over $1,000 for a watch during this first year, giving careful consideration to what I purchased. Yeah, I purchased watches in which I lost interest and later sold off. I consider these experiments to determine what I like and what I don't like. Am I just rationalizing my bad behaviors? Maybe. No. I slowed down considerably since my early days of watch collecting. Last year, in 2021, I purchased just two watches. This does not mean that I still don't see watches I like. Virtually every week, I discover a watch that piques my interest. Watches from all price tiers. So why don't I buy them? Well, I've come to realize that I'm limited by the number of watches I can readily appreciate in my collection. By appreciate, I really mean wear. I have about 10 watches in my collection that I regularly wear. I have others, mostly sentimental, that I only wear on special occasions. When I had more watches, I found that there were some watches I couldn't wear for many months. At that time, I was still working. I usually picked a watch from my collection to wear all week, maybe switching during the weekend. Given that schedule, it might take several months before every watch in my collection got wrist time. I didn't like that. It felt like I was ignoring some really fine watches. So I reduced my collection considerably. This doesn't mean that I won't be acquiring more watches. It just means I'm even more selective than I was a few years ago. Just because there is a watch I admire doesn't mean it should be in my collection. It would seem that the irritation I get from having watches I don't wear is stronger than my craving to obtain a new watch. What makes it worse is that I really like all of the watches in my collection that are in my normal rotation. I can't see selling any of them in the near term. Seems like this might be a catch-22. I like all of the watches in my collection, so I don't see selling any of them. I really want to add to my collection, but adding to my collection will cause some watches to be ignored, which I hate more than not getting a new watch. Therefore, I can't add to my collection. So where do I go from here? Well, luckily, I think I can add a few more watches before I have too many to enjoy. But if more watches means just one or two more watches, what do I get? This will take some thinking. I'll get back to you in an upcoming episode. So make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon so you're alerted whenever I upload a new video. Is this a common evolution for watch enthusiasts? You tell me, what was your path in this hobby? Do you consider that you are or once were a watch addict? Let us know in the comments below. Here's my latest video on the state of my collection, and another video on a history of watch advancements. I think you'll find this very educational and something that adds to your enjoyment of the hobby. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.